Hi everyone, my name is Kerem.
I'm Ferhat.
I'm Kaan.
I'm Melih.
I'm Nilay.
In our project, we thought of an app that enables students to sell their second-hand school materials on an online platform. In this app, students can find and buy the necessary materials, or they can sell the materials that they do not need anymore. The app is focused exclusively on university students, so only university students will be able to register. We have done this in order to create a much more reliable environment. We have created our app for Android Studio, Android platform. We are implementing our project in the MVC architecture design. So here's our model classes. There are admin classes that are created in order to keep certain features. User classes that model the certain functions of users. And for example, post classes will store the data for the post. Post is to, again, store the post, is chat. Message will, all the other classes will do similar things. Our activity adapter and fragment classes will be acting as our controllers, where we are creating the mechanism and where we are updating certain model data. And our views will be the layouts that we have created in the app video.
Now I'm going to introduce the technologies that we used in our app. We are using Firebase as in order to store the users' information in a server, and also we are using Java Mail API in order to send verification mail or sending reports in order to inform the admins. I want to introduce the login and register page. We can log in and we can register. If we register, there it will check it's an EduTR mail or not, and it will send a verification code to our EduTR mail, and this is an example. Okay, let's log in. And we are in main menu, and here there are four buttons that navigate the user to other activities. And I want to hand it over to Kaan right now.
Thank you. And I will be showing you how the post list screen works. So this screen basically displays all the posts that exist in the database. Here, the user can scroll through all the posts and filter and sort them according to their preferences. Upon clicking these buttons on the top, the posts will be sorted like alphabetically or considering their price from low to high or high to low. And also on the top right of the screen, we have the filter option. This will pop up. This will open a new pop-up screen where the user can filter the list according to their preference, again, by university, by course, or by applying a price range. This will again filter the list. And also on the top of the screen, we have the search bar where the user can type in an input, and again, list will be filtered according to the user's input. And on top right, we have an icon where this icon will redirect the user to the create post screen. And clicking one of these posts will open the post screen where detailed information about the post can be found. And our friend Kerem will be explaining that screen.
Okay, thank you. This is the post screen where the user can see the details of the post that they have clicked, the price, the seller, the description of the post, and the picture. On the top, there is a toolbar that has four different buttons. This will take you right back to the previous screen. There is a home button where you can click directly if you don't want to click the back button multiple times. There is also a report button where you can send your reports to us through the mail. If someone writes a report to here, it will come to us. There is also a wish list icon where when we click this, it will add the item to our wish list. And also there's a chat button where we, when we click the chat button, it will take us to, for example, in this post, it will take us to a chat screen with Melih Fazıl. This is the My Chess screen where users can see their chess with other users. There is a search bar where you can filter the chess by their username. And by clicking on one of the chats, we can start to chat with a user. When we type a message and press the send method, send button, we send notification to other user. For that, we use another API, which is called a send notification pack to send notification. Also, we use Firebase cloud messaging service. And in the chat screen, in the toolbar, you can report the user, or you can go back to the main menu, or you can block the user and don't get any message from that user, and don't see their post, his posts.
Also, I would like to add something as well. When someone messages you, you will get a notification which indicates that there is a message that is sent to you.
Yes.
Okay, now I will open the wishlist. Mira, you can talk about it.
Okay, thank you. This is a wishlist screen. In this screen, users' favorite posts on the screen. When heart button is clicked, users move the post from their wishlist. Also, this is my post screen. In this screen, users can see their profile pictures, their usernames, and their user types. And below them, their own posts can be seen clearly. And by clicking edit button, users will be sent edit post activity. And then, when specific post is clicked, the post detail screen will appear. Also, when they click tick button, they can remark their post as sold or unsold according to current situation. Moreover, they can create posts by clicking the add button. Now, Kerem will explain edit post and create.
Okay, so when the user clicks the create post button, they will be directed to a new page. They are forced to enter a title and a price for their post. And when they click the apply button, this post will get created for and will be added to the post list and database. In the edit button, when we click the edit button, the user can change the specific information about the post. On the top bar, you can click the remove button in order to delete the post. When you click the apply button here, it will get updated in both post and database. And for example, when we change the price, the users who have added this post to their wishlist will be notified. Let's try it. When we click the let's click the apply button, and I have opened another emulator. I have it in my wishlist, and there is a notification saying that, as you know, the price has changed. And now I'll go to the settings. Farhat, you can explain.
Okay, in settings activity, users can change their avatars and they can reset their password. And if the user they click on the reset password button, then they will get a message. And if they say yes, the link will be sent to their email in order to reset their password. And they can send feedback to us. They can type anything and they can block, they can see the users they have blocked. Right now I have not blocked anyone. If I block, it will appear right here. It works totally fine.
Okay, now I will briefly talk about the admin features. First of all, admins can delete any other post that they see unfit. For example, if this post is not appropriate, the admin can delete it by clicking the admin delete panel. If I click yes, it will get deleted. And there's also an admin panel where we can see reported users. When a user or a post gets reported, the report will get mailed to us, and the person who gets reported will be shown in here. Their report number will increase. And when I click this button, the user will get banned, and they won't be able to use that.
As a reflection, this project was a new experience for all of us. We worked hard to complete all of my duties which we mentioned in our previous reports. I hope we have finished the project successfully. We didn't know about designing apps and using databases before this project. Also, we had no experience about MVC except Lab. Now, we are more experienced and familiar with coding as a team. Thanks for listening.